correcto, es el darwinismo, la teoría de evolución es la correcta.
Yo pienso que los caracteres no influyen en la descendencia.
Bueno, la probabilidad que existe de que eso pase es baja.
Pues que hay una parte que evidentemente viene determinada por la herencia genética tal cual la conocemos, o sea, los genes que vivimos de nuestros padres, etcétera, etcétera, pero hay otro componente que es epigenético.
Epigenetics refers to the study of mechanisms that control gene expression states without changing underlying DNA sequence, unlike genetics. These changes in DNA packaging are potentially transmissible to daughter cells. There are several epigenetic mechanisms which include DNA methylation, which consists on the addition of a methyl group to the cytosine nucleotides, post-translational modification of core histones proteins. This includes various modifications, but the more important ones are acetylation and methylation. Action of non-coding RNAs that are transcribed from DNA but not translated into protein. They interfere with mRNA, blocking their transcription. Prions are amyloid aggregates. When they interact with proteins, the interaction leads to the loss of the function of that protein. Amyloid aggregates are able to segregate prion particles to daughter cells after cell division. All these mechanisms produce changes at different levels that are thought to be inheritable. This transmission is called transgenerational epigenetic inheritance. The changes can happen in response to environmental stress in the neighborhood of transposable elements. They can also take place under conditions of rapid environmental change in order to create genetic variation. However, the epi allele is not 100% inheritable, because it does not follow a Mendelian manner. Another problem of transgenerational epigenetic inheritance is the phenomenon known as reprogramming. During development, a totipotent cell, the zygote, must divide, giving rise to many different specific types of cells. During the process of gametogenesis, the ovule and spermatozoid acquire certain specific characteristics that are regulated by epigenetics. These characteristics must be deleted in order to form the totipotent cell. This is why most of the epigenetic variations won't be transmitted to the offspring. As a result of this, the epi alleles that are acquired during the life of an individual are reprogrammed after the gametogenesis. However, there are some epigenetic marks that remain untouched during the development of the individual. Why some alleles delete and some others don't remains unclear to this day.